After logging into the software with an employee ID and password, you will be brought to the invoice screen. Here is where you will process your transactions. To add items to the invoice, put the cursor in the Scan Barcode Now field and scan the barcode. To add items to the invoice that don't have a barcode, select Search up at the top. Enter text to search for an item by, and then select Search. This will filter the items based on what you searched by. Highlight an item and then hit Select. This will add the item to the invoice. For another way to add items to the invoice that don't have a barcode, select TS Lookup on the right. Select the departments on the left to filter out the items in that department. You can use the arrows at the bottom to navigate through the departments and the inventory in the selected department. Make your selection, and then select Done. At the invoice screen, we can also edit items on the invoice. To perform a price change, select the item you would like to edit, and then select Price Change. Enter the new price and select OK. To change the quantity, or the number of items that are being sold, select Quant Change. Enter the new quantity and select OK. To discount an item, select the item to be discounted. Select Discount, then enter the percentage off. When done, select OK. If you would like to delete items off the invoice, select them, then select Delete. To do a price check, select Price Check at the bottom right corner, or select F5 on your keyboard. Then scan the barcode of the item. When done, select Exit. To close out a transaction, select Pay. This will bring up the Amount Tendered screen. Here we will choose how the transaction will be paid. Choose the tender type that you will be accepting. At the bottom you will see buttons representing dollar amounts. These are quick cash buttons. The one all the way to the right represents the next dollar amount up. To pay it to a split tender, select Pay, and using the keypad on the left, type in the amount that you would like to pay out to the first tender type. Then select the payment method, in this example, cash. This process can be repeated so that you can accept multiple tender types for one transaction. To do a return, log into the software and add the item that the customer is returning to the invoice. Select Quant Change and change the quantity to a negative number. You will see that the total is now in parentheses, meaning that the customer will be receiving this money. Select Pay, then select the tender type that you will be paying out the refund to. To set up other options for returns, select Setup, then Setup Screen. Select the Invoice Settings tab. Optionally, we can choose to log returns, select the customer for the return, and prompt for a reason for the return. To set up reasons for the items to be returned, select the Reason Codes button. Select Add, and then enter a reason for why an item would be returned. For example, wrong item. Then select Enter. Then Exit, and finally Update. When returning items to the invoice, you will be prompted to enter the original invoice number. When done, hit Select. Select the reason code, and then hit Select. Optionally, you can choose to enter an alternate reason for the item being returned. To associate invoices with customers, select Find from the invoice screen. Enter search text to search for the customer by. If the customer does not exist in the database, we can select Add Customer, which will bring us to the customer maintenance screen. Then select your customer. Add your items to the invoice as you normally would, and then select Pay. Select the tender type that the customer will be paying with, and close out the transaction. To view a customer's sales history, open up Customer Maintenance and select Lookup. Select your customer. Select the History tab. You will see a list of the transactions that this customer has processed. When done, select Exit. To pay out transactions to the customer account, we must first configure the customer's account to accept on-account transactions. Open up Customer Maintenance and select your customer. Select the Account Info tab. Under Open Account Date, select the O button. Optionally, we can choose to set a Close Account Date. Select Update to save your changes. At the invoice screen, select your customer and ring up your items as you normally would. Then select Pay. For the tender type, select On Account. To view the customer's account balance, open up Customer Maintenance. Then select your customer. Select the Account Info tab. Select the Detailed Account Info button. Under the Invoices tab, you will see a list of the invoices that have been paid to this customer's account. Under the Payments tab, you will see a list of the payments that have been applied to this customer's balance. To apply a payment, select the payment transaction type at the bottom. Select the invoice number. Select the payment method. And then enter the amount. Select Apply Payment. And close out the transaction. When done, select Exit. Be sure to select Update to save any changes. Then select Exit.